فؤادك الأيام فتى
تستعمل قرعة عند المبهم من الحقوق أو لدى التزاحم. The Sheikh is talking about an issue called قرعة. قرعة is what? قرعة is to throw throw an arrow, the Arabs used to do, in order to do for things that are unclear to you. You don't have a particular what? You don't know who to choose. A man's married to four wives. He wants to travel. Hey, who's he going to take? This is عند المبهمي. All of them are here. Hey, who's he going to take? He uses قرعة. من الحقوق, the responsibilities. أو لدى التزاحمي. Or when things are, they are overcrowding each other. They're both, you have to choose between two things. Well, they're on top of each other. You have to choose one. And you don't know which one to choose. You're allowed to what? Two people are fighting over the adhan. Tazahum. No, it's mine. The qura. Does that make sense? Two people are fighting over the adhan. Qura is being done. The wife and the man, he does qura for his wife. They all want to come with him. He does qura for them. Ah. And there are evidences for that. The Prophet ﷺ said, لو يعلم الناس ما في النداء والصف الأول. If the people knew what was in the first line and the adhan, ثم لم يجدوا, and they will not be able to find إلا أن يستهموا عليه لاستهموا عليه. They would have budged each other, fought against each other to do what? To be first line or do the call of prayer. So if they do argue one another, what's going to happen? A qura is going to be placed. Are you with me? So the qura is used for two times. The qura is resorted to at two times. The first one, the Sheikh already mentioned it. عند المبهمي. It's used when something is what? It is not directed at one particular person. Everyone else falls under it. They are as, meaning everyone has the right for it as much as the other. That's called mubham. You don't know who's all right. He's allowed to do adhan and he's allowed to do adhan because they're both as qualified as one another. Ajib. There's no way to distinguish between the two. All your wives have rights to come with you. Yeah. No one has rights over the other. Not because she was the first one, or this was the second one, this is the third one, and all that. They all have rights as much as each other. So how do you say who's going to come? This is ibham. It's not known. Also, the second time it's used is عند التزاحمي, when two people are actually budging and pulling and pushing on each other on a right. And sorry, the issue of the adhan, it falls under tazahum, sorry. The issue of that, they're all both fighting over the adhan. It's tazahum. The qura is used. عند المبهمي is something different. It's not, the first one I mentioned was not عند المبهمي. This is عند المبهمي. عند المبهمي is what? A man, he divorces one of his wives, and he narrowed down which wife it was. He said, Fulana is divorced. Are you guys with me? He divorced a wife. After a while, he forgot who he divorced. Which of them was the one I divorced? And this man has to let one of his wives go, because he's 100% sure he divorced. But he's unaware of which one. He does qura. Whichever one comes out from, she's the divorced one. He does it be what? Bi wasitatil qura. Any woman, it comes out through the qura, because he's mubham. No one's known who's it, which one. It could be all of them, one of them. Whichever one it comes out, he can't look at the one he hates the most and say, I hate you the most, alhamdulillah, it's my chance to let go of you. And he lets it go. لا, عند المبهمي, he results to قرع. نعم. Very good. So those are the two times that the قرع is used. عند المبهمي وعند التزاحمي. وإن تساوى عملان اجتمعا وفعلت إحداهما فاستمعا. The Sheikh said, if two actions, and this is called, this qa'idah is called qa'idatul tadakhul. Two actions, both of them, both of them are min jinsin wahidin, they are the same thing. Both of them are the same thing. Like for example, the voluntary prayer of dhuhr and tahiyatul masjid. Are they not the same? Are they not the same? They are the same. Good. They're both salah, they're jins wahid. By praying the voluntary prayer of dhuhr, it will uplift from you the tahiyatul masjid. Because they are what? Both of them are what? Both of them are the same jinns. They're the same type. And there are two conditions that the ulama stipulate and they mention for it. Two conditions have to be met. The first condition is أن يكون كل من العملين من جنس آخر فإن كان ليس من جنسه لم يدخل فيه. The tadakhul has to be two things. That both of them are what? أن يكون كل من العملين, that the two of the actions من جنس آخر, it has to be from the type of the other one. فإن كان ليس من جنسه, if it's not from his jins, لم يدخل, he will not enter it. They have to be the same jins. Example would be for that. لو كانت المرأة عليها عدة ثم وطئت بشبهة. A woman, pay attention. She was what? She was in state of she was in a state of talaq. She got divorced. A man divorced her. لو كانت المرأة عليها عدة. Her عدة was in. ثم وطئت, and then intimacy was done with her by way of شبهة. Maybe she didn't know the مسألة. The hukum wasn't clear to her, and the person who got married to her, both by way of shubha, they got married. وَالْوَطْءُ بِشُبْهَةِ لَيْسَ مِنْ جِنْسِ وَطْءِ زَوْجِ الْأَوَلِ. The second man, she doesn't take an idda from him. She sticks to the idda that was already there because the second man's idda has no weight, or the intimacy that he had with her. فَلَا تَدَاخَ الْعِدَّتَانِ هُنَا. She doesn't, the two iddas don't enter. And there's a mas'ala that many people confuse, which is تَدَاخُلُ الْعِدَّةِ. The iddah, can it enter onto one another? This is the issue. Inshallah ta'ala, my plan is to speak about it in the issue of marrying a woman without the permission of her wali. Because this is the place where it comes to us. The issue of nikahu shubha. The second condition that has to be met is أن يكون أحدهما ليس مقصودا لذاتي. The second condition is that action should not be something that is intended in within itself. They all have to be what? They all have to be what? Something that are not intended in and within themselves. وَكُلُّ مَشْغُولٍ فَلَا يُشَغَّلُ مِثَالُهُ الْمَرْهُونُ وَالْمُسَبَّلُ. The Shaykh talks about a matter which is here, on the 45th line. الْمَشْغُولُ لَا يُشَغَّلُ. You bought a product from a person. And when you bought this product from a person, they took something from of yours, are you with me? They said to you, okay, akhi, you want to buy this barley, you want to buy the dates, you want to buy the clothes. It costs £5. Say, akhi, I don't have £5. Or, akhi, I need food, I'm really hungry with my kids. He said, okay, no problem. Give me a watch. He takes your watch and he says, whatever you bring, give me back the money, you'll take it. This is now called rahan. He's keeping it for you. He's not allowed to sell it. Huh? Until what? You don't bring the money back. He'll take it and he'll sell it, and whatever he gets from it is his. Whatever it becomes is his. That's what's called rahan. Are you with me? You are not allowed. The one, so Zayd came. When Zayd came, he wanted dates and food for his kids. I looked at him out of mercy for him. I said, Akhi, you know what, take it. Give me your watch. Took his watch, he kept it here. Or give me your phone. Took it from him, he put it here. So whenever you bring your money, inshallah ta'ala, your phone is yours. I'll just keep it here. Now, Oyen, the brother Zayd, he's not allowed to go what? He's not allowed to go and try to sell the phone that's with me. Try to sell it on the market. Say, look, I've got a phone, I'll bring it for you. Don't worry about it now. This is already busy with something. وَكُلُّ مَشْغُولٍ. Everything that is busy, فَلَا يُشَغَلُ. You can't make it even more busy. It's already busy with somebody else's ownership. They're the one, until they said to you, here it is, they give it back to you, then you can sell it if you want to. مثاله, the example is al-marhun. Marhun, something that's kept. And that's our messenger as well. Our messenger, his dirra. His dirra that he wore, a Jew man took it from him like that. The Prophet wanted something to eat, he couldn't be able to pay for it, so the man took from him the Prophet's armor. He took the Prophet's armor. Good. Also, what falls under this is that a brother, they're conversing over a business trading and they're busy with one another, and you come and you try to put a bay on top of it. It falls under it. لا يبع بعضكم على بيع بعض. Some of you should not try to sell on one another. Are they not busy with one another? كل مشغول فلا يشغل. How can you try to come in and try to say, look, أخي, look, I'm just saying, innit? I can offer better. And he walks away. Nah, لا يجوز. It's not allowed. So a lot of things fall under this issue in which a sheikh. Also, the musabbal is al-mawquf. The mawquf. Something that is given by way of waqf. A person takes mushafs and Qur'an and stuff like that. What does he do? He gives it to the masjid. Nah, that is not allowed. وَمِن مُؤَدِّي عَنْ أَخِيهِ وَاجِبًا لَهُ الرُّجُوعُ إِنَّوَا يُطَالِبًا. The sheikh says here, an issue which is paying off somebody else their responsibility on them. Somebody's got debt on them, and you go, you pay off that debt for them. Are you allowed to ask for your money later? You went out of your way, you paid it for the person, without their permission, you knew they were suffering, you went, you paid for it, and you came later and you said, Akhi, I paid for your debt. Yeah, how much? Can you give me back the money, inshallah ta'ala? I'll wait for you longer than the brother. Is he allowed to? We spoke about it before. When we're talking about wajibat, there are wajibat in which intention doesn't enter it. A person doesn't have to, intentions, ما لا يدخله النية. ما لا يدخله النيابة, sorry. That which another person can't take your place for it. There are some obligatory acts in which a person is not allowed to take your place. No one can take your job for this. Such as Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. No one can say, I'll pray for you, brother. Whenever you know I get sick and I can't pray, remember you're going to do it for me. La. No one does that. The second type is, ما تدخله النيابة. Somebody else can do it for you. The second type is somebody else can take it for you. And that's like Hajj. Now pay attention to this. Can somebody else do it for you? Yeah? Can you do it without your permission? He just went and he Hajj and he came back and said, guess what? I did Hajj for you. La, that you didn't do Hajj for that person. That Hajj has to be with that person's permission. Huh? It has to be with his permission. Naam. What about if he's dead and he's passed away and he's not alive? That's another issue. Number three, it is al-huquq التي لا تتمحض أن تكون عبادة مثل النفقة أو مثل السداد الدين. It is rights that they're not ibadah in and within itself. It can't be with your intention, but it's not ibadah in and within itself. Like funding your family, giving them money, paying off the debts that you have. So because it's not the second type that you need the person's permission. It's not the first type where nobody can do it for nobody. So it's the third type where it's not even ibadah aslan, the debt. The person goes, meaning the paying off is not a debt. The paying off that debt is not an ibadah. Unless the person intends, Ya Rabbi, I'm only doing it because you ordered me and your Ya Rabbi, and I'm only doing it so I can have the... That's niyyah, like in بمجرد الفعل. So the question here right now is, هل يستحق ما أداه? Do you have the rights of what you paid off for him? Two situations. إذا أدى عن غيره حقا وهو لا ينوي الرجوع إليه. If you paid it off, when you gave it, you didn't intend with your mind, you weren't intending to get it back from him. So you paid it off. And when you paid it off from him, you didn't intend to get your rights from him. That wasn't your intention. Then you're not allowed to ask for him. And if you ask for him, you're going to fall under the hadith of the Prophet. العائد في هبته كالكلب يقيء ثم يعود في في قيئه. It's like a dog, a person who takes back his gift that he gave. He gave a gift, and he wants to take back the gift that he gave. It's like a dog that vomited and tried to eat his vomit. So it falls under that. If the person, like it, he intended. The person, he what? أن يؤدي هذا الواجب الذي لا يتمحض أن يكون عبادة قد يفعل على وجه العبادة وقد يفعل على وجه غير عبادة بإذن صادر من الذي عليه الحق فهذا لا يجوز له الرجوع بالإجماع لأنه إنما تصرف بإذنه فهو مثابة والوكيل. He fulfills for him, the second type is what? The second type, sorry, is that he fulfills that obligation, which is not a, it's not a ibadah. Lakin, it can be done in a form of ibadah. And it can be done in a form that is not ibadah. From the and بِإِذْنِ الصَّادِرِ مِنَ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِ الْحَقِّ فَهَذَا يَجُوزُ لَهُ الرُّجُوعُ بِالْإِجْمَعِ. That person is, has the rights to take back. He did it for him. He paid it off for him. It can be an ibadah and it can't be an ibadah. We both. And he goes and pays it off for him. He has the rights to ask for that money in return. And he takes the ruling of a wakil. But who gave him the permission? The individual gave him the permission. The person goes, pay for me. He's allowed to ask for his rights later. So, Akhi, can you pay that money off for me? Ah. He went and he paid. Even if he said, I'll give it back to you, it doesn't matter. It's like a wakil. It takes a wakala. It is like, this money now became yours already. The money, you ordered me to do it. It becomes your money, and you'll have to pay me back later. I can ask my rights later. Whether you can give me it back, whether you have to give me back or not, it's another situation, it's another khilaf. Like, I have the rights to ask you for that money. Because you told me to do it. Number three. The third one is the one that's Baytul Qasid. It's a person, and you add the haqq an ghayri, nawi an rujoo. You pay off somebody else's debt. You intend that you're going to get it back from him, but he didn't give you permission for it. This is the mas'ala the fuqaha took time out. Safahat, pages. They discussed it and they spoke about it. Khulasa is what? The Hanabila, they see annahu yajuzu lahu rujoo ilayh. The Hanabila see, yes, it is permissible. The Malikiya, they also see the same. That is the choice taken by the author, AbdulRahman Nasir al-Sa'id, rahimahullah ta'ala. And that is what the apparent essence of the Nusus show. Because Allah says in the Qur'an, هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. He done good for you. What's the reward for him accepting good? Na'am? Good. Also the hadith, the Prophet said, مَنْ صَنَعَ إِلَيْكُمْ مَعْرُوفًا. Anyone who does good for you, فَكَافِئُوهُ. Reward him. Reward him. Allah also says, فَإِنْ أَرْضَعْنَا لَكُمْ. If a woman breastfeeds you, فَآتُهُنَّ أُجُورَهُنَّ. Give them their ajr. You see, even that though they what? They never took those prior permission from you when they breastfed you. Na'am, so it falls under there. The last qa'idah, the sheikh says, وَالْوَازِعُ الطَّبْعِي عَنِ الْعِسْيَانِ كَالْوَازِعُ الشَّرْعِي بِلَا نُخْرَانِ. The sheikh is talking about the sins are two types when it comes to the people's nature. Our nature, the sins are two types. Those which are what? Those which are in the human being's system, we don't even like it, aslan. There's a nu' min al-nufra. We run away from it. We don't like it. Are you with me? Is it permissible to drink urine? No, it's not. It's najis. You're not allowed to drink it. Would anybody do that like in? Adatan, no, unless a person who loses his fitrah. Like in, it's a sin to drink it. You will be sinning to drink it. But pay attention to this. Your taba'ah doesn't like it. Some people, they don't like alcohol. Taba'atan. I can't drink that, man. It smells bad. Taba'atan. Are you with me? Very good. The Sheikh said, that is the same as what the Shari'ah dislikes. Both of them are what? They're both the same. Now also you have to remember is, things that your system is inclined to is one type of the people's nature. People are what? They have what? There's two types. There are what? There are two types. Some which the person loves, he's inclined to. The way you get sinned for that one is the same as the one you hate. They're both the same. There's no difference. In the eyes of the Sharia, they both have the same. So the Shaykh is saying, وَالْوَازِعُ الطَّبِيعُ عَنِ الْعِصِيَانِ كَالْوَازِعُ الشَّرْعِي بِلَا نُقْرَانِ. All of those meanings are in it. All of those meanings are in it. Also, another thing that falls under this issue is the Sharia, some issues it didn't talk about. Because the word Allah placed in you that this thing. Will you find any text that directly says that you're not allowed to what? drink, eat feces. Will you find it? The Sharia went silent about it. Why did the Sharia? إِنَّمَا اكْتَفَى بِذَٰلِكَ الْوَازَى. The Sharia sufficed itself with the nature in which it created you with. Are you with me? Are you guys there? نعم. وَلِذَٰلِكَ the أحكام of the Sharia, sometimes the ulama, some issues, they say it's haram because it goes against the وَازِعُ الطَّبْعِي. Even if they don't bring evidence for it. نعم. They say that. Nowadays we have people who can cause harm on the internet. They'll use the internet and they can destroy a person's life. Are you with me? They can physically cause a person harm without even being with them. Are you with me? Hey, where's the ruling for that in the Sharia? Where would you get that the Sharia spoke about this? This is referred to as wazi'ul jibili. Your nature automatically knows all of that which you did is wrong. And the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ mentions, "Wal ithmu ma haka fi sadrik." The ithm, the sin, is what your soul doesn't regurgitate. Keeps thinking, bringing it back to itself. وَكَرِهْتَ أَنْ يُدِسْلَيْكَ أَنْ يَطَّلِعَ عَلَيْهِ النَّاسِ. That the people see you doing it. Allah created that in you as a human. But if the person's one gets tainted, that goes. It goes. So some issues, you won't find any uquba from the Sharia in which it connected to this issue, except by what? Al-wazi'u al-tab'i. The sin that comes, so the Sheikh is trying to say to you, anything that comes through your nature, that is, it goes against, it's the same as what the Sharia made haram. They're both the same. Going and eating feces right now is haram as going against it if the Sharia was to say it. Naam. The Sheikh finished his book by saying, Alhamdulillahi ala tamami. Praises to Allah by completing. Fil badi in the beginning. Wal khitami and the ending. Wal dawami and forever and continuously. I mean, praises to Allah at the beginning of our start of this book, the ending that we finish this book, and wal dawami and continuously until the day of judgment. Thumma salatu, salutation. Ma'a salamin, with peace. Sha'i'in, that is spread. Ala nabi, on our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وصحبه and his companions والتابعي and those who followed him. We finish there inshallah ta'ala. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, رزقنا الله وإياكم صالح الأعمال وجنبنا المعاصي والزلل وصلى الله وسلم على عبده ورسوله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين بإحسان إلى يوم الدين.